Heavy Bag Boxing TV.
Y'all make sure you go subscribe to my man Heavy Bag Boxing, baby.
Get your dumb ass in here and hit this bag.
The Heavy Bag Boxing TV.
Y'all just go ahead and subscribe to Heavy Bag Boxing TV because he be lit on his shit.
And Heavy Bag Boxing.
Heavy Bag Boxing TV.
Yo, shout out to Heavy Bag Boxing TV.
Heavy Bag Boxing TV.
Heavy Bag Boxing TV.
Hey, oh, Jalo. Oh man, I almost ain't even want to do this video, y'all. I'm actually starting to feel bad for Jermell Charlo now. Y'all been on that boy's head ever since he's lost Saturday night to Canelo Alvarez, and it continues. And I think he messed up when he said he was doing it for the culture, because the culture has responded. Let's talk about it. What up, YouTube? Big T.O. Heavy Bag Boxing TV. Man, get your goofy ass in here and hit the bag. Hit that like button for your boy. That helps the channel. You know, I appreciate that love. Shout out my gang, man. D1 Merc 1ML 21 Skinny JT Black Jesus. My guy, Troy Jack. Key One, Rebel Life, Modern King, Letitia YK World. My guy, Tyree Celestine. Big shout out to More and More Network. My guy, Big Sean. Shout out my Aussie family. I see you out there, Mark Wynn. Now listen, the culture can be mean. Now listen, when you say you putting on for the culture, you better represent, and you better represent right. You can't make statements like I'm putting on for the culture and not do a superb, outstanding job. And that is far from what Jermell Charlo achieved Saturday night versus Canelo Alvarez. And the culture has the culture has spoken. I got some audio I want y'all to listen to coming straight out of what it is. It is what it is. Come Talk to Me, featuring Cam'ron and Mace. And this was their thoughts on the fight Saturday night with Canelo and Jermell Charlo. Damn, Charlo. Roll that beautiful beam footage.
Well, when Mace just said that we didn't meet him at the game and everything, and it was my fault, I feel like it's his fault for dragging me to that motherfucking fight. I can't get them 2 hours back in my life, man. That's probably the worst fight I've seen in person, and I don't know how fucking long. Yeah. I have no idea what the fuck. I do have an idea.
Yeah.
Charlo, you fucking sold us out. You said you did it for the culture. What culture? The track culture, nigga? You was running the whole fucking fight. We seen it. And then you was looking scared. Not only that, we in there now. Think about this. You in the stadium, right? First of all, we don't want to get too out of pocket because the cartel is there.
Yeah.
This mad Mexican's there.
Yeah, there's so many Mexicans. It's a Latin fest.
Yeah. So we was like, listen, man, we only thing we got, only one we got here is Charlo. Because if you said something too crazy, them Mexicans was ready to go crazy and jump niggas. You ran.
Ran all fight.
Let me go, Murder. You dragged me to this fight.
Okay.
So we even with the Colorado shit, because I really wasn't that impressed to go to the fight. Because I told Bob, did I tell niggas? I said nigga was going to fuck Charlo up anyway. But what he didn't do, he ain't even fuck Charlo up because Charlo was running. Y'all niggas been calling this nigga out for like 3-4 years. You and your brother been calling Canelo out. He been telling y'all niggas y'all do not want these problems. Y'all end up getting the ring and you got the problems that he told you y'all didn't want. Then you call out Bud after the fight. You just looking for fights to make money at this point. What I suggest is this. Fight Errol Spence. We'll see where the coach goes. What's his name, Derek James?
Yeah, that's what I said.
Okay, go ahead, Myrtle. What happened?
I said that when they fight, who will the coach go with? Derek James. Who are you going to coach if Errol Spence fights Charlo? Who is he going to go with?
Who gives a fuck? His top two fighters lost. He trash at this point. Nobody give a fuck about that, nigga. I don't know how he won coach of the year, trainer of the year, whatever the fuck
trainer
he was.
Trainer of the year.
That nigga's garbage. So at the end of the day, you need some new fighters. The best fight that we probably want to see is your two fighters against each other. I don't even want to see Charlo against Bud. Because Bud's a monster. That nigga Charlo's feet was off, fumbling. Like, he looked like a nigga with no coordination. A nigga was running. I'm looking at his face, and you could see what we seen on the instant replay. When the punches was coming his way in slow motion, he was like.
He was like.
He was scared. That nigga was scared. Yeah, he kept doing that. Nigga.
I was just like,
you went in for a check, my nigga, and you were embarrassing, and you saw this.
And his brother was taking pictures with Bud.
Whole thing about it is this, and I ain't trying to start no shit and no shit, nothing like that. It's like this, bro. The nigga who smacked the shit out his brother was in there walking around dolo. White nigga. The other brother got three security guards with him walking around the arena. Three security guards. Nigga smack fire out you. You don't want revenge? You ain't gonna pick up a chair like you was in Alabama, nothing. Yo, my nigga. Nigga smack stone cold dog shit out you, nigga. And you walking around with security? White nigga walking around like, what's popping?
Yeah.
I don't got no respect for the Charlos. No disrespect to nobody who fuck with them, but they embarrassing y'all niggas. You got a wife, you got kids. Niggas seen you run that whole fight. Then you gonna call out Bud afterwards. Listen, me and Murder left when the bell hit. When soon as round 12 was over and the bell rang, we ain't safe for a decision. We ain't safe for shit. When we got outside, the nigga, Terrence Crawford was already outside. I don't even know what round he left it. He had to leave like round 10. Like, yo, I'm not sticking around to watch this bullshit. That shit was bullshit. And yeah, I'm mad you took me to the shit, Murder.
Yeah, oh. I was trying to be a friend of the year. I flew in from Denver to take Cam to the fight.
That shit was trash.
It was garbage.
Damn. The culture has spoken. Damn, Charlo. That's all I got for y'all on this one, man. Harsh words from the culture. Big Teal, Heavy Bag Boxing TV. Talk to him, Roger.
Most motherfuckers don't know shit about boxing.